Better Horses with Ernie Rodina is brought to you by
Silver Spurs Equine and Silver Spurs Saddles.
Hello friends, I'm Ernie the Horse Guy and welcome to this week's episode of Better Horses TV. We've got an unbelievable show.
Sir, take your hands, interlock your fingers, place them on top of your head.
We're out here with the Kansas City Mounted Patrol in Kansas City. You're going to enjoy that segment. I'm going to take you to Indianapolis, and you're going to meet a young lady named Breana Carsey. Tremendous story. You're going to love that. Take you down south to Phil Haugen in Weatherford, Oklahoma. Unbelievable. Get yourself a cup of coffee. Get yourself some snacks and come back and join us with Better Horses TV with Ernie the Horse Guy.
That's right, it's Oldies Radio.
Where is this?
And remember,
place?
It's Big Bingo Day at the horse track.
There it is.
Life can be full of surprises for you and your vehicle. With Lucas Oil's fuel treatment, you're ready for them.
Hey, you're holding up the line. These guys are racing for pink slips.
Bring it on, Sonny.
Lucas Fuel Treatment gives cars of all ages the edge they need.
Go!
It cleans your car's entire fuel system, improving mileage, taking you to the finish line. Take home a winner with Lucas Fuel Treatment.
You care about your animals and feeding them the best. And that's where Purina's local Kansas City dealers step in, providing you experience, knowledge, service, and advice. Purina feed dealers are people who believe in community involvement and who believe in you. They have a passion for the feed industry and are committed to helping customers unlock the potential of every animal. If you are looking for a trusted source for your animals, look no further than your local Purina feed dealer, your partner in animal care.
Hi, this is Pastor Frank with Open Range Fellowship, and it was almost 2,000 years ago that Jesus wasn't found in his tomb. He'd risen from the dead this very morning. That's called resurrection power. And guess what? If you're a follower of Christ, you've got it too. Isn't that awesome? Lord, we just come before you this morning. Just claiming this, that we're going to live forever, that we can have eternal life through your shed blood on the cross. And Lord, we just love you and we praise you in your name, Jesus. Amen. And let's go live like we have resurrection power. Let's go live like we are going to live forever. And let's tell others how they can live forever too. So I'll see you next week and God bless.
Back in the saddle and out on the trail with Ernie the Horse Guy, now fun will prevail. We'll meet the best horsemen under the sun. Tip our hats to the ladies, keep the good Lord number one. Ride along, sing your song, along with better horses, we're right where we belong. Faith and love above, the best of the good laughs yet to come.
This segment is brought to you by High Performance Lucas Oil Products.
Hello friends, I'm Ernie the Horse Guy and welcome to this exciting episode of Better Horses TV. I'm here and it's such a privilege to be out here with Kansas City's finest, the Kansas City, Missouri Mounted Patrol. I'm here with Sergeant Joy Roberts, the supervisor of this great team. Thanks for inviting us out here with Better Horses TV.
Appreciate it.
Tell us what's going on here. I remember it started in 2006 and look where you came to.
Yep, it started in 2006, and you know, now we've got, you know, 6 full-time officers, 1 sergeant, and a couple of reserves, and we are busy all the time.
I tell you what's really here, nothing but exciting things happen up here, and what you're used for, and tell us about a typical day with the Mounted Patrol up here. We're on the top of like Swope Park up here. This is home to you guys, and
this
is where you guys congregate and go out there on your duties. Tell us a little bit about a typical day.
Well, a typical day here, because you know, we take care of everything. We do all the stall maintenance, build fence, you name it, we do everything here. So when we first come in, it's all about horse care. We're getting horses ready for deployment that day, and if an officer is off for whatever reason, his horse will get turned out in the pasture, and we'll pick an area to deploy, one of our project areas where there's a lot of high foot traffic, crime, and just go out and be visible, communicate with the public. We do a lot of activities outside as far as like going to schools and talking to kids at schools, preschools. So we do quite a bit of that stuff. There's a lot of special events. We're on the plaza every Saturday night.
What a great job for an animal lover, for a horse lover. And I imagine a lot of these, your unit, never were around horses until they started here and becoming quite the horseman.
Oh yeah. Everybody but one of these officers had zero riding experience when they came here.
Well, just a great job. It has to be a dream ride. And I tell you what, we're up here, we're going to do a demonstration, kind of how you get these horses used to the elements. You know, these horses, a lot, you buy some of them are donated, and we're going to get into that later. But you get these horses ready for the going out on as far as on the beat and everything with some exercise. Could you share that with
us? I sure can. Matter of fact, I'll step out of the way here for a second. This horse right here, he's a full Percheron. And through our not-for-profit, we're in the process of purchasing him. So today was his very first street ride. We've been working in the arena, but today he actually went out on deployment, out on the street. But all of the exercises that you see in here are all the obstacles. It's all about building confidence.
And this horse has really not been ridden hardly at all.
No.
He was a carriage horse,
yeah,
like
he was
said.
A carriage horse through Bobby McGee with the Plaza Carriages. You know, I've known him for several years now. And, you know, we've been trying to identify a horse that had some time doing the carriages on the plaza. And then now we're transitioning him into a riding horse for our needs. You know, one of the things, you know, they get exposed to a lot of the traffic. Now, mind you, they have blinders on, but it kind of gets them a good starter for, you know, some of the things that we expose them to.
I can't help thinking, Dan, you're not the small stature. Seeing Dan on this Percheron, it can be pretty intimidating.
Oh, yeah. This guy, I mean, we haven't weighed him yet, but he's somewhere between 1,800 and 2,000 pounds. And he's a force to be reckoned.
Let's see what he can do.
All right. Well, the first thing we'll demonstrate is going over the bridge. And this is one of those things. It's a different elevation change. It's a different look to it. You know, horses, what we want to do is build confidence in them. You know, and he doesn't know that thing is going to support his weight. So you've got to build trust between the rider and the horse that he's going to be able to step on that and survive and be good with it. Dan, you want to take him through the trash pit?
Yep.
This trash pit back here is real good too, as far as being able to get confidence in the horse, because it's going to be really noisy. The footing is unstable. So what he's got to do is he's got to have enough confidence between Dan and him that he's going to be able to walk through that without getting caught up and survive it. And the more things that you expose these horses to, like this, and they survive, that's how they build confidence.
Wow.
So that's a real good exercise. Now, this exercise over here, these turnstiles, this is kind of an introductory to crowd control. Because when we're out there patrolling in crowd, you're going to have people reaching out, touching the horse and all that stuff. And, you know, we got to know that the horse, if he gets touched, he's not going to jump sideways. And he's got to be confident with it. And then, obviously, pushing through an obstacle builds into the actual crowd control portion. So Dan, you want to take him through? And you can kind of see he's still kind of tentative about this, especially now that it's moving and it's touching him and it's like, oh my gosh, am I going to survive this? You know, he kind of took a little hurried step. The goal is, you know, to get him to a point where he just doesn't even care and he'll just, you know, blast right through it and not even be at all worried about it. Because when we get into a crowd, I mean, you know, we want him to push through stuff and not be worried about being touched or push into pressure.
Yeah, I have to say, you know, I know you're proud of your horses and what you, and your unit up here, but how proud Kansas City and the area is of where you've taken this mounted patrol. You know, it's pretty much, I remember when it got started, it was kind of on a trial type of era, but I mean, we would be lost without you guys, and we expect to see you at these events and everything else, and I know that means a lot to us to see these horses and see what you're doing with them and everything.
Well, we appreciate it. I tell you what, it all starts with, you know, getting good horses and good-minded. It takes a particular mind of a horse to do this job. And, you know, a lot of our training is based on herd instinct. You know,
now, this horse, particular horse, came from a client that in its former life, it was in dressage,
oh,
if
yeah.
I was correct.
They come, we've got barrel racers, dressage horses, cow horses, reiners, trail horses, and carriage horses. Well, so, a little bit of everything.
Just unbelievable. But how proud we are with what you're doing there. And you know what? To tell you what, we're going to come back and we're going to talk a little bit about what we can do. And we're going to do a little demonstration of how you handle the bad guys out there.
All righty.
So you're listening to Better Horses TV with Ernie Rodina. And we're here with the Kansas City, Missouri Mounted Patrol. We'll be right back.
What do you get when you bring together one of the biggest names in veterinary medicine with one of the most caring and committed teams of horse health experts in the industry? You get a vaccine portfolio known for its quality and safety, a pharmaceutical line you can rely on to help manage pain and support performance. You get the products, programs, and people of Merck Animal Health.
Hi friends, I'm Ernie the Horse Guy, and I want to talk to you about Better Horses Properties. If you have a property you'd like to list and sell, I'm the guy to contact. When it comes to marketing, we're second to none. We've got the publication. We'll promote your place in the publication. We'll promote it on our radio networks. We're going to promote it on TV and our e-blast. Better Horses Network is your direction to go when you're looking to market your horse property. So contact me at ernie@betterhorsesradio.com for your property and let us go to work for you.
This segment is brought to you by your independent Purina dealers.
Hello friends, Ernie the Horse Guy back here with the Kansas City, Missouri Mounted Patrol with Sergeant Joey Roberts, and just been great to be out here. And I want to ask you, what can we as the public and equestrians, horse folks, do for you to help? We had the trail ride we called down in downtown Kansas City last year, and we're going to have it again in August. Tremendous event.
Yes.
And Cowboys for Cops.
Yes, it was an excellent event.
And what can we do? You got a great organization, too, as far as the Friends of the Mounted Patrol. How can we get involved and what can we do? What do you need?
Yes, we have a 501c3 called the Friends of the KC Mounted Patrol, and without them, we wouldn't exist. I mean, they pretty much purchase everything that you see here, including some of our horses. And as far as helping out, anything that, you know, people can do to help out with the Friends, we're always looking for memberships. Obviously, monetary donations is great. If you have a draft cross horse, gelding, 6 to 12 years old, you know, we take donated horses. That, you know, any of that kind of stuff would be very much helpful.
And the neat thing about it is, you made the comment, we're still a ways from a hay crop. You could use some hay.
Oh, yeah. You know, we strictly use brome hay, and, you know, right now we're... You know, we're going to be pretty thin getting to this next season. So we may be looking for some hay.
Well, I would urge folks to join the Friends of the Mounted Patrol. Great organization. You got great community support. And, you know, it's just so proud to see what you guys are doing. And you go through a lot in harm's way. You know, we know that you're not supposed to dismount when you're making an arrest. Show us the procedure, what happens. If you're going to make arrest, it seemed almost impossible to do it on horseback, and that's not true. So I'm going to play the bad guy, which, by the way, I'm innocent, but we're going to go ahead and do that right now and show our viewers what takes place out in the field.
All right, will do. All right, Officer True. All right, sir. Come over here, sir. Come right over here. Put your hands on top of my horse. Okay, what we're going to do now is we're going to do what we call an interlock. I'll have the suspect put his hands on top of my horse. We'll get him locked in here using our feet, the horses. So pretty much right here, the only way he can get away from us is if he drops to his knees and crawls underneath the horse, which I don't hardly see people doing that. So I've got to get a hold of him. Sir, take your hands, interlock your fingers, place them on top of your head. And what this does, this is going to help me control him. If his hands are interlocked and I can squeeze, he can't break his hands apart. And I'll kind of put him off balance a little bit, lean him in, and then that'll also make a little room for my partner to put the cuffs on. Sir, take your right hand, place it in the center of your back. Okay, I've still got a hold of his other hand. He's gonna place the cuff on. Okay, sir, take your left hand, place it in the center of your back. Now I'm gonna grab, change my grip, make sure I still got a hold of him.
I'm innocent. I'm innocent.
Okay, you got him?
Yep.
All right, Mike, you take control of him, and I'm going to spin around. And now we're going to take him into the escort position. So if we're escorting him over to a wagon, I'm going to make space. Come around. Sir, watch your feet. Now we'll grab hold of him. All right, sir, walk straight forward. Make sure you watch my horse's feet. I don't want your foot to get stepped on. Okay, now we'll escort him to the wagon or wherever we're going with him.
The moral of this is, crime doesn't pay. I'm innocent. They never saw me take the Oreos. Thanks for joining us with Better Horses TV.
Your buddy Ron once said he could install your ceiling fan. He couldn't. And that one time, Ron said another chili dog was a good idea? Yeah, it wasn't. So when Ron said you'd never afford a John Deere tractor, you knew better. Now, Ron does too. The E-Series. Legendary John Deere quality. Unexpected low price.
Stop by and see Heritage Tractor at one of its 9 locations for your John Deere and Featherlite trailer needs. HeritageTractor.com.
Hi, I'm Donna. This is Ringo. We're with CSI Saddle Pads. I'd like to invite you to ride our new revolutionary FlexPlate saddle pad. We offer a 30-day money-back, ride-it, get-it-dirty guarantee. And the best part of the pad is it's 100% American-made with American parts by American hands.
I've been using CSI pads for 16 years, and there's a reason behind that. It is a total performance system for me. I just can't say enough about them.
For more information, go to CSIPads.com.
Better Horses with Ernie Rodina is brought to you by your friends at Merck Animal Health.
Hello friends, I'm Ernie the Horse Guy and welcome to this episode of Better Horses TV. Had the opportunity while I was back at the Hoosier Horse Fair to meet a couple of superstars. And I tell you what, this is such a neat story. You got to hear about it. And I'm here with Breana Carsey and your brother, Jordan Carsey. And what a story. And I happened to watch the story on the CBS episode a little while ago, just a tremendous deal. Tell us a little bit about what this is all about, Breana.
Well, it's all, the main thing about everything is God. That's the main thing that my message was about. I always wanted it around God. Everything that happens on the world is because of Him.
And what happened was you had this mare that had a colt, and this colt you knew was going to be good.
Yes.
And we're talking about trotters.
Yes.
From that standpoint. But no one else thought this horse was going to be very good, right?
Yes.
But what was it about this horse that you were 8 years old at the time?
Yes.
What was it about this horse that really reached out at you?
Well, when he was born and he was laying on the ground, I saw Jesus picking him up and saying, you gotta have faith in this one. And then MJB started walking and Jesus disappeared. So I've always had faith no matter what.
And we're talking about Team Carsey. We're looking at MJB Got Faith. That's the name of the horse.
Yes.
MJ and Jordan, you're the brother.
Yep.
And MJB Got Faith, you knew this horse was gonna be a winner. And it could, the story could end right now in what happened. But what happened to this horse? You gotta tell the viewers. What happened? You wasn't trained, didn't he? Qualified.
Yeah, but he didn't qualify good. He almost didn't qualify. So then everybody was like, you might as well sell the horse now. He's not going to be good at all. And I said, well, you got to have faith in him. And his first race, he won. And everybody was like, you were just lucky that race. He's drawed soft, which means he had an easy race. Because you were just lucky in that race. I raced second. He won again.
Won again, too.
And they kept saying, you drawed soft. So then he ended up winning his third, his fourth, and then going into the championship. There's another horse that was for 8 for 8. And he was going in the championship.
And that horse, the horse he's going against was 8 for 8 wins.
Yes, and that horse was huge. And everybody said, the best you're gonna get is second. And I said, no, you gotta have faith. And my dad said, well, if he doesn't win tonight, you might as well be happy. I said, Dad, if he gets first or last, I'm going to be happy with him. Best, but I know he's going to win.
And so he ended up winning, and when winning the thing, how much did you win with Team Carsey?
$100,000.
Unbelievable, $100,000, the horse still going good. He's was a top two-year-old, if I'm correct, in the state of Ohio.
Yes.
So what's the plans next for Team Carsey and also MJB Got Faith?
To keep racing and to keep having our faith in him and every horse that we own from now on.
I'd like to wrap it up too. This little girl won $100,000. What did you do with the money?
Donated it to people that needed it.
But unbelievable. And then the other half, what do you want to do with it?
Save it up for college and for a farm.
Unbelievable. What a great American. Just a great young girl, a great sister, a great brother, and a great family here with Team Carsey at MJB Got Faith here at the Hoosier Horse Fair.
The restoration of live horse and greyhound racing in Kansas will generate over 4,000 jobs, nearly $300 million in annual wages, and $23 million in new annual revenue. Reinvigorating racing at the Woodlands and three other Kansas tracks also creates superior destination entertainment districts in Kansas. The Greater Kansas Racing Alliance is working to restore our horse and greyhound racing industries, putting Kansas in the winner's circle. Visit raceforkansas.com to show your support, and let's race for Kansas.
You care about your animals and feeding them the best. And that's where Purina's local Kansas City dealers step in, providing you experience, knowledge, service, and advice. Purina feed dealers are people who believe in community involvement and who believe in you. They have a passion for the feed industry and are committed to helping customers unlock the potential of every animal. If you are looking for a trusted source for your animals, look no further than your local Purina feed dealer, your partner in animal care.
One of the main reasons for poor vehicle performance is a dirty fuel system. It can cause decreased fuel economy and actually do harm to your engine over time. By adding mucus fuel treatment to your vehicle, it cleans and lubricates the entire fuel system. Pump, carburetors, fuel injectors, and valves as you drive. It also improves your vehicle's performance. It's a non-solvent product designed to protect both gasoline and diesel engines. Mucus fuel treatment, it works.
This segment is brought to you by CSI Saddle Pads.
Hey Ernie, thanks for having us on your show, Better Horses TV, this week. For this week's training tip, I'm going to talk about collection at the lope. And when we're talking about collection at the lope, first two things you need to have is at a walker trot, you have to have great lateral flexion. And you have to have great vertical flexion right here. You have to have your horse getting behind that bridle. If you don't have that at a walk and a trot, you're sure not gonna have it at a lope. But the main thing I'm gonna talk about this week is which rein hand is your collection hand when you're loping a circle, whether it be in the arc or the counter arc, okay? So when you're loping your circle, your horse in a circle in the arc with their nose pointed into the circle, your outside hand is going to be your collection hand, and I'm going to demonstrate that right now. Okay, so when I ask my horse to move out and start my circle, I'm going to use my inside hand, which would be my left hand, to slightly tip this horse's nose to the inside of that circle. Now, if I don't feel like my horse is behind the bridle, I'm going to gently rock this outside hand to help get my horse more collected and to keep my horse more behind the bridle. You know, it's really important that with movement and as your horse picks up speed and you perform your events or whatever discipline you're in with more speed, it's really, really important that that horse still stays soft and stays behind that bridle. Because with speed, when that horse stays soft and behind that bridle, they're going to stay nice and round in their back. They're going to stay nice and round in their turns. And it doesn't matter if you're roping, running barrels, doing a cow horse event or a cutting event. The more that horse can stay soft and round, the better off you're going to be. Okay, so that's keeping your horse collected One lope in a circle with their nose tipped to the inside. Now, I'm going to do the same thing while I counter arc my horse's body, meaning my horse's nose is going to be tipped to the outside, which the counter arc, what it does is helps you straighten this horse's shoulder, move this horse's shoulder in, and also move their hip in, okay? So this time, when I'm loping in this circle, I start out loping my horse in an arc, okay, with his nose, her nose tipped to the inside. Now I'm gonna drop my inside hand and pick up on my outside hand, okay? So my horse's nose is tipped to the outside slightly. Now my inside rein becomes my collection rein. And as you can see, as I lope around in that circle, I might gently bump that inside rein to collect my horse more. Whoa. Okay? A lot of times, like at my clinics, what I see happen is when someone's trying to collect their horse with forward motion going in a lope or a gallop, they're using that inside rein too much sometimes, or the rein in the direction they're going and not that outside rein, or vice versa. Like in the counter arc, when you have your horse's nose tipped to the outside, this isn't your collection rein. This rein right here is. That's the rein that collects that horse, okay? So those are two things that when you're doing simple exercises, which everybody's gonna probably lope their horse to warm them up every day you ride them, when you prepare for whatever discipline you're doing, those two exercises, think about that when you're collecting your horse at a lope. Always think about which hand is your collection rein and which direction your horse's nose is going. If your horse's nose is tipped to the inside, your outside hand's your collection rein. If your horse's nose is tipped to the outside, your inside rein is your collection rein. That's this week's training tip. Ernie, thanks for having us on this week. And everybody, remember to watch Better Horses TV each week. And you can also go to our new channel on Better Horses Network to see more of our videos. Thanks and have a great week.
I hope you had as much fun as we did today with Better Horses TV. So glad you joined us. If you'd like to see some past episodes of Better Horses TV, you can go to betterhorsesnetwork.com and listen or view it, because it's going to be posted on Better Horses TV with Ernie Rodina. Also, check out my radio show every Sunday morning at 9, right on KCMO Talk Radio 710 AM or FM 103.7 FM. If you or your company are interested in being a part of Better Horses TV with Ernie Rodina, contact me for some sponsorship opportunities at Ernie at betterhorsesradio.com. We'd love to have you on our team.